You are one of the sons that should be brought in today into this kingdom of God. That's why you are in church. If you are in church and you are not born again, you are just wasting your time. And you are heading towards a dangerous destiny. The devil also has destinies for those who disobey God. So you are hearing this clarion call this morning that you should consider this as a very important thing. Please, I beseech you by the mercies of God. You cannot afford to go out of this service this morning without being absolutely sure that you are born again. If you are not born again, when the altar call is made, please run forward and come and receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Because you are a sinner that needs a Savior. And Jesus Christ is the Savior. His arms are wide open to receive you. No matter how grievous your sins have been, no matter how numerous they are, His mercy is still dangling over your head. Oh, that you will allow it to drop into your life. I pray you will do so in Jesus' name. The second category of people we'll be praying for are the people who know, looking back at your life, you can say categorically, it was because I made this or that decision that I'm suffering what I'm suffering today. Hear me very well. You made certain decisions at certain stage of your life before today, and that decision has landed you in an unquantifiable sorrow, heartache, and pain. For some, it borders on who you married. You look back, you say, how I wish I didn't marry this man. How I wish I didn't marry this woman. For some, it's based on your business. You've lost so much. And you are looking back and say, it was at the point I made this decision to invest in this or that I lost everything. For others, it could be also in your profession. Some, they look at themselves, they are not happy with the job, the profession they are engaged in today because of certain decision they made at a crossroad junction. They had alternatives to study this or study that. They said, no, this is where everybody is going. That's what I want to go, where I want to go. And they went that way, but today they are not happy. I thank God for the mercies of God over my life. I was at such a crossroad when I was in 200 level. I had the opportunity. I was admitted to read agronomy. 100 level, 200 level, I did very well in all the courses in agriculture. In fact, I was the second best in Agric Economics courses. And many people were telling me Agric Economics is the best of the agricultural courses. And I wanted to change. And of course, I did change. Wait now. This God is wonderful. Some of you might have heard this story before. I went to then Professor Adegeye. He was then Dr. Adegeye, Agric Economics. Of course, my professor here knows him very well. He was the coordinator of the courses. So I went to him. I said, sir, I want to change to Agric Economics. He said, what is your name? What's your matric number? I gave him and he checked. He said, you are very brilliant. You are good. Yeah, have you obtained the change of course form? I said, yes, this is it. I gave it to him. He signed me in. I went to my department, then Dr. Umwezi. He has just retired as a professor in the Department of Agronomy. I told him, sir, I want to leave agronomy. He said, why? I said, I just want to go. I said, no problem. Where is your form? I gave him. He signed me out. All that remained was just for me to take the form to the exams and records. So I held on to the form, and of course I've been signed out, I've been in agronomy, and I've been signed in agric economics. So I started attending lectures in agric economics. But I noticed that anytime I went in for the lecture, I couldn't concentrate. I was troubled. So one night I prayed. I said, God, this is a crossing, a point of decision. It's a crossroad. God, what will you have me do? So I had a dream that night. In the dream, I saw myself taking the form back to agronomy and telling then Dr. Omueti that, sorry, sir, I'm no longer changing. And he said, okay, where is the form? Have you submitted the form? I said, no. I'm talking of what happened in the dream. I said, no. He said, okay, fine. Since you have not submitted the form, go and tear the form and come back. So the following day, when I woke up from the dream, I said, this must be God. Of course, all this while, I've lost my peace. So I went to meet him, Professor Omueti. Then Dr. Omueti, I told him, sir, this is what I'm experiencing. I said, sir, I don't want to change it. And it happened exactly as it was in the dream. And the moment he said, tear the form, the peace just came back to me. I will never forget that turning point in my life. Decision. And I thank God that I did not read Greek economics. I thank God that I read agronomy, that I'm a soil scientist today. Because by the time I was graduating, I was the best student in soil science. And I had an award. I've told you some of the stories of what happened on the day of convocation. When some unbeliever boys sitting around where I was sitting in the trenchard hall, when my name was called to come and shake the hand of the VC to be given the award, they were saying, SU has award, SU. They were surprised. Decision. There are some of us here, God wants to change your story. You've made certain decisions that have landed you in serious trouble. And you are saying, is this how I will end it? Is this how I will be living my life? Turn with me to the book of Joel. Joel chapter 2. God asked me to tell you this. This is what he wants to do to you. Joel chapter 2, verse 25. It's also a very familiar passage. Joel chapter 2. Says, the years the cankerworms, the palmerworms, the caterpillars, and the locusts have eaten, I, the Lord, will restore. And that's what the Lord wants to do for someone, some people here this morning. The Lord wants to turn your story around. If only you will release yourself to Him and say, Lord, yes, I've made this grievous mistake. I've entered into a wrong relationship. I've burnt my fingers. I've done what I should not do. Lord, please have mercy on me. Our God is a God of second chance. That you are alive today, it shows that God wants to do something for you. God wants to turn your seat. It will spring forth. God will restore. Restore the lost years, restore the lost joy, restore the lost hope, restore mind to do the will of God. As we have always been told, when the counsel of God is about to fulfill, satanic opposition will try to arise so that you are facing certain challenges. Does not mean that God has abandoned you. No. You just stand with the commands of God. Stand with what he has commanded. And you will see that your destiny, which has been put in Christ, will ultimately see you through that situation. He saw me through. He will see you through. At those critical moments, and then the third category of people are those who are currently in the valley of decision. They are saying, should I take this? Should I take that? Should I go this way? Should I go that way? They are kind of confused. This morning, by the grace of God, you will receive guidance. By the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Spirit of God will guide you. As you become sincere with God, as you tell the Lord, God, I want to please you. Lord, I want to obey you. Lord, I want your blessing. I may not know how, I may not know when, I may not know the avenues through which you will work out things. I just want to be in your perfect will. I want to obey you. If you will make up your mind to do that, then you will find out that you will smile at the storm. Don't give in to pressures. Don't look at issues just from the facial presentation. As it's popularly said, not all that glitter is gold. Not all that glitters is gold. And it's, I have this strong burden in my heart that there are some of our brethren, especially with the issue of relationship, getting marriage partner, you are in a fix. You look, you know, as God made it, the sisters are always at the receiving end. Whether it is good, they are the receiving end. If it is not so good, they are the receiving end. That's the truth. And so you, sister, you are at this crossroad. You look at brother A who has proposed. You think, hey, the potential, the promise over his life is this. You look at brother B. He's not looking so promising. And you are using all this to gauge what your decision should be. You are likely to make a mistake. Why not turn it over to Jesus? And say, Lord, look at these three brothers. They have proposed to me almost at the same time. Which is your mind? Out of them, or maybe none of them is even of your mind. So that as we begin to pray, you will pray your heart towards God. You want to take a job. One of our brethren who listened to BSG, based in Port Harcourt, phoned me some 3 days ago. And he was telling me that he had job offers. He's a younger graduate. He's not yet married. And that he had a job with Air Force and another job with a GIS, Geographical Information System outfit. And so his people told him, Air Force, a job that every young person should run for. Why not take it? Go for it. He was to report in Abuja. This other job in Port Harcourt. So he went to Abuja to take the job. He said he went to Abuja, took the job, and started the training. He said after 2 weeks, you know, he knew that he has lost his peace. He couldn't fit in. He just left the training ground, went back to Port Harcourt to take this other job. He said, since he took this other job, he was always happy. He was always full of joy. He was testifying on the phone. He called me to tell me that. I said, that is it. You are on the right path. The Lord will take you to the destiny he has for you in life. Because, ordinarily speaking, Air Force job is highly promising. We all know it. No be so. But not all that glitters is gold. I'm not saying that Air Force job could not have been the mind of God for him or for any other person. So don't get the analogy wrong. Okay? Some of us, some of our brethren, we have to be in Air Force, Army, Police, name them. If that's where God is leading you, be sure it is God leading you there and pursue that career. Brethren, as we begin to pray, you will pray, first of all, thanking God. Shall we be on our feet? We read in Deuteronomy, God says, if you obey my commands, these blessings will follow after you. If you will do my will, you will eat the fruit of the land. If you will follow me and obey my instructions, I have a place for you in heaven. Jesus Christ said in that John chapter 14 from verse 1, in my Father's house, down to verse 6, said, I will come back to you. I'm going to prepare you a place. I will come back and take you to myself. Anyone who decides against Jesus cannot follow him when he comes. There's no argument about it. So for those of us who are born again already, I want you to begin to thank God for the glorious destiny you have in Christ Jesus. Remember Jeremiah 29:11. God said, I know the thought I think towards you. They are thought of good, not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. Thank the Lord for how the Lord has brought you this far in life, if you are born again. But if you are not yet born again, your life is not yet secured in the Lord Jesus. And so you are not heading for heaven. You are not heading for the glorious destiny God has in store for you. And I want you to come forward. While others are thanking God for their salvation, you come and receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. No matter how grievous your sins, your past has been, come, please, quickly. We don't have much time. Come. Come and give your life to Jesus. You cannot continue to pretend that you are a Christian when you know you are not. Oh, my shekekelia. Thank you, Lord, for the glorious destiny I have in Christ. Thank you, Father, for my name is written in your book of life. Thank you for your mercy over my life. Thank you for redeeming me from the pit of hell. Thank you for, by your strong hand, you have delivered me and translated me from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of your dear Son. Lord, I'm grateful. Is there anyone who wants to come into this estate of receiving the power to become a child of God? Go ahead and pray. Lord, please grant me continuous grace always to make right decisions leading to my destiny in you. You have come this far in life. There is still a long journey. The journey is still long or short before you. Will you tell the Lord, please, I need grace. I don't want to miss my way. I don't want to miss my step as I follow you. As I obey your command, may I not be caught up in the web of distractions that the devil tries to bring against me. Lord, I receive of you grace, continuous grace, to make the right decisions leading to my destination in you. Oh Lord, Nikalia Rada Kada di Kapashtama Sukupraya Leka Payala de Kikele Mama Santokolia Rada Kadi Kaposhte Mama Engama Santa Kele Masanta Kikele Arade Rika Pashtu Mama Sunkupraya Kikele Kikikedia Krade Kikedia Rabashtima Eka Bayandelia Ragalia Radiki Poshtimo. Pray that I will not miss my destiny in Christ. I will not sell my birthright. You know the case of Esau. because of that decision, that singular decision not to be able to hold his appetite, he threw his birthright away. He said, what is birthright to me? Give me the porridge and take the birthright. The Bible tells us at the end of the day in Hebrews that he sought to get it back with tears, but it was too late. Don't wait until it is too late. This is the time to say, Lord, I will not miss my destiny in you. I will not sell my birthright. What is that the devil is dangling before your face? Say, compromise now. After all, everybody else is doing it. Everybody else is going that way. Will you continue to suffer this way? And you are saying, maybe I should give in. No, maybe I should just do it. And after all, I will go back to God and say, I'm sorry. Ah, you are playing with fire. This is the time to say, God, please help me. Help me. I will not miss my destiny in Christ. I will not sell my birthrights. I will make it. Jesus made it. I will make it. Jesus made it. I will make it. I put my trust in the Lord. I will make it. Jesus made it true. I want us to pray for this category of brethren. God really impresses so much upon my heart. Those who are suffering as a result of previous wrong decisions they made. You look at your life, say, it was because I made that mistake. I decided to take that job. I decided to marry that woman. I decided to marry that man. I decided to stay in that house. You know, some people, they have options of two houses. And they went for one. Because they didn't seek the face of God well. Only to get to that house, one sickness after the other. One problem after the other. And you are in that kind of situation. Or whatever aspect of your life, you know that the condition you are in today is as a result of the wrong decision you took. If you will just take a step of faith and come forward, the Lord says, I will restore to you the years, the canker worm, the palmer worms, the caterpillars and the locusts have eaten in your life. The Lord, the gracious and the merciful God, we restore back to you. Brethren, the rest of us, I want us to stretch our hands towards these our brethren and begin to pray for them. That the word of the Lord will work for them. The Lord is the restorer. Is the restorer. Is the restorer of that which the devil has stolen. The devil has stolen your joy, he has stolen your peace, he has stolen your destiny. But today the Lord says, I will restore, I will restore, I will restore. Oh my God, legege bronika pastande. Rigalanto kupraningre de lo postinge de angra dalo unstima santa kikaya. Those of us in the front, kneeling down or standing, as the case may be, just place your hand on your chest and be telling the Lord, Lord, I remember. It was because of this decision I made some years ago, some months ago, some time ago, that has landed me in this present problem, in this present situation. Father, please forgive me. Please have mercy upon me. Let your word come to fulfillment in my life. Let your word of restoration come to fulfillment in my life. The Lord says, I will restore to you the years that the locusts had eaten, the canker worms and the caterpillars and the palmer worms, my great army, which I sent unto you because of your disobedience. Because you refused to seek my face at that instant. You refused to listen to my instruction. That was why you got into that trouble. That's why you have been suffering this much. But today, I'm restoring. I'm restoring. The Lord says, I'm restoring. I'm restoring. Masekete li gradado. The Lord is the merciful God. He says, though your sins be as red as crimson, they shall become white as snow. Oh, come, the Lord says, come, let us reason together. He said, if you will be willing and obedient, then you will eat the fruit of the land. Then I will restore joy unto you. I will restore your destiny. I will restore your destiny. I will restore your destiny, says the Lord. Please, brethren in the audience, stretch your hand towards them. Let the mercy of the Lord descend upon them today. Let the mercy of the Lord speak for them. Let the mercy of the Lord speak for them. Let the mercy of the Lord intervene. For with God there is mercy. With the Lord our God there is mercy. Mercy, Lord, according to your word. Let your mercy prevail over these our brethren, kneeling down or standing up before you. Mercy. Lord, you impressed this so much on my heart concerning these brethren. Lord, I pray, let there be a new beginning, a time of refreshing, a new beginning, a time of refreshing, a new beginning, a time of refreshing, a new beginning, a time of refreshing. Because for some of us leaning down here, the devil has been opposing you. He has stood against your prosperity, against your advancement in life because of that decision. But the Lord has arisen on your behalf. He says it's restoring back to you. Oh, payendali kaprali kapayalade. Lokum palenge de la ratohu ushtema sante kikelia. Thank you, Jesus, for you are the merciful and gracious God. Thank you, Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name we have prayed. In the name of Jesus Christ we have prayed. Eternal One, compassionate God, merciful Lord, behold this your children, kneeling down before you or standing up. Lord, they have owned up to the fact that they have exposed themselves to the devil because of a wrong decision. The devil withstood their joy, their peace, their advancement in life. But today, Lord, you have promised, and you are a covenant-keeping God. You are faithful to your word. You are not man. You are not man. You are not human beings that deceive others. Lord, you said you will restore. Restore unto them the years the palmer worm, the canker worm, the caterpillars and the locusts have eaten out of their lives. Father, let the past be rolled away and let there be a new beginning for them in the name of Jesus. Every pointing of finger of accusation at you by the devil and his cohort, we rebuke this hour in the name of Jesus. devil, we rebuke you. We say, take your hands off the destinies of these children of God. In the name of Jesus, you enforcer of wickedness, you satanic demons that have been pummeling the lives of these ones, you've stolen their joy, you've stolen their peace. We rebuke you now. We say, take off your hands from them. In the name of Jesus. For their Redeemer is mighty. Their Redeemer is strong. Their Redeemer has come. Devil, you have no right anymore over them. Be gone from them. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord sets you free. The Lord sets you free. The Lord sets you free. Enter into the fullness of the destiny that you have in Christ. By the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Receive your joy back. Receive your peace back. Receive the assurance of God. Receive your full benefits in Jesus. That from this hour, you begin to enjoy that which the Master had paid for. He has paid for your peace. He has paid for your joy. He has paid for your destiny. Yes. Receive. Receive. Receive your home back. Receive your job back. Receive your profession. That which heaven had ordained for you, receive them. For those the Lord will change the hearts of their spouses. Lord, you know what you will do. After all, your word says, even the heart of the king is in your hand. Like the course of the river, send you direct it to wherever you will. For those of you who have this challenge of your spouse not being in the same book with you, you know that that is the bane of your situation. Lay your hand upon your chest. Lay your hand upon your chest now. Father, behold this, your children. Let it be a turning point today. You know their spouses, wherever they may be, whether in this auditorium or outside. Lord, touch their hearts. Amen. Cause them to come together again. Amen. Do a healing work, oh God, of these relationships. In the name of Jesus. For you are the God of a second chance. Bring them back together. That love which they profess to have for one another at the beginning, let there be a restoration of that love. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We bless your name. We praise you. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Go back to your seat and continue to rejoice in the Lord. The Lord has restored back to you. And as they are going back to their seat, the second set of people, quickly, are those who are at the valley of decision. And you are sort of asking, which one is the correct one? Lord, should I go left or should I go right? Or should I remain in the middle? You want to obey God. You want the will of God to be done. You want God to be glorified. You want to please Him. But you don't know where you should go. Come to the Lord. Come to the Lord. And the Lord will give you a token. I told you of my own story. Maybe I wouldn't have been here today if that decision was not made rightly. Oh, thank you, Jesus. God is faithful. He's not an author of confusion. You just make up your mind as you are coming to the front that you will obey the word of God. That any decision you will make from this moment, as the Spirit of God reveals to you, it will be in line with the word of God. Come on, Santa Kilia. Please, brethren, let the rest of the church stand up again. Stretch forth your hand towards our brethren, that the Lord in His mercy will show each of them the way forward, the way forward, the way of peace, the way of glorifying God, that which will please God. They want to know the mind of God. They want to know where the Spirit of God is leading them. Please let us pray for them. Pray for them. Pray for them. For some, you are saying, should I resign this job and take this other one that is being presented, or should I remain? Whatever be the case, begin to tell the Lord, God, this is my situation. This is my situation. Where shall I go? What should I do? Oh, Father, my Father, my Father. You are not an author of confusion. Lord, arise for the sake of this, your sons and daughters.
Arise, O Lord.
Reveal your counsel unto each of them. Show them that which is your perfect will, wherein they will find peace, wherein they will find joy, wherein they will find fulfillment. Lord, they are at the crossroad. Father, please show them your mercy. Please show them your grace. Show them your love. Take away confusion from them. You did it for me. You are still the same God. Do it for them too. My Father, my God. Do it for them. Give them, each of them, a testimony that in a no distant time from now, they may be able to say, Lord, guided my footstep. God guided my decision. Just tell the Lord, I will obey you. Whatever you tell me, even if it doesn't tally with what I think it should be, I will obey you. You are saying, whatever you say to me, I will obey you, Lord. I will obey you. Wherever you send me, wherever you send me, Lord. Father, once again, we present our brethren before you. Jehovah, King of glory, their destiny is in you. Their future is in your hand. They want to obey you. They want to be led by your Spirit, the Holy Spirit. That's why they have come. Jesus, you said, no one that comes unto you that you will in any wise cast away. Father, Father, your word says they will hear the voice behind them saying, this is the way, walk therein. When they turn to the right, when they turn to the left. Father, that from this moment onward, every form of confusion be taken away from them. In the name of Jesus, let them hear your voice. Let them, those that must see vision, those that must have the dream, those that must hear your voice, audible voice, please speak to them. Let none of them go astray. Lord, your word says, whatever is committed into your hands, you are able to keep unto the uttermost. We commit them into your hands for safekeeping. Keep them. And whatever the devil may be dangling to distract them, to confuse them, we break such into pieces now. In the name of Jesus, we expose the deception of the devil and his cohort. They will no more hold water. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. For they will come back with testimonies of your gracious dealings with them. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Can you go back to your seat? As you go, march into the perfect will of God for your life. I want the rest of us to begin to pray. Lord, help me. Keep me on the track of my destiny in Christ. Lord, keep me on the track of my destiny in Christ. And so you are telling him, I have no wisdom of my own.
I have no wisdom of my own. I depend on you, Holy Spirit of God. I have no wisdom of my own. Power of my own.
Father, this is our submission. You know the way through the wilderness of life. You know the glorious end you have ordained for us as individuals in Christ Jesus. And you know, Lord, the distractions on the way. The subtlety of the devil and his cohorts. That's why we depend absolutely on you. Of our own selves, we can do nothing. The arm of flesh, we fail. The wisdom of men, we fail. Lord, we do not have any power of our own. We pray that you will help us to keep looking unto you, the author and the finisher of our faith. Keep us following after you, because we know that you are leading us to the glorious destiny in Christ. And so, Lord, we pray that none of us in this assembly, and even those who may also listen to this message in one form or the other, wherever they are on the surface of the earth, Lord, grant grace. Grace. Grace to continue to follow you, to obey your word. For it is in obedience that we have peace. We have fulfillment. It is in obedience to your word that we will make it to the end successfully. Thank you, Father. Receive all the glory. We pray that beyond our asking, you will continue to do unto us because you love us. In Jesus' name, we have prayed.